British spy babes, sultry CIA sidekicks, and even hottie henchmen. These are the women that have fallen under his spell. Hello, and welcome to another edition of Comedy Central's Spyography. I'm Robert Culp, and tonight, we turn our spyglass on one of the fastest growing populations in the world today. Women who've been shagged by Austin Powers, and those that want to be. We'll get up close and personal and between the satin sheets with several of these lovely ladies. We'll come to understand who they are, why they are the way they are, what they find so mysterious about the International Man of Mystery, and how I can get their numbers. So, join us for this very tingly edition of Spyography, The Women of Austin Powers. That is what I'm talking about.
Austin Powers couldn't be here because he's on a very special mission. Somewhere in Thailand.
Bangkok?
No, he wore a cup. So, you know.
The dancing, gyrating mojo master that is Austin Powers. In the air or underwater, with his customary high-density polyester or without, the exploits of this time-traveling international man of mystery are legendary. He's photographed or shagged some of the most shaggable women of the last four decades. In the 60s, there was Mrs. Kensington and Felicity Shagwell. In the 90s, Vanessa Kensington. And most recently, Foxy Cleopatra. All have had their reasons for dating him.
Austin, you know, it's their mojo. You can't resist their mojo, man.
He's charming, suave, debonair, extensive knowledge of fine wine.
I think his character's really lovable.
He's adorable.
He's naughty. He's from the 60s. He smacks your bottom and says, hello, pussycat.
Oh, behave.
According to Austin's boss, Basil Exposition, part of Austin's appeal comes with the job itself.
I certainly have noticed that this designation, International Man of Mystery, has had the most extraordinary effect on the female sex.
He is the International Man of Mystery. You know, I don't think you can overestimate the effect that that has on women.
I've been concerned that he simply could not cope with this, the sheer massive outpouring of female interest and the sheer pulchritudinousness of the assault on him.
Despite the fact that no one is certain if Basil just made up that word or not, Dr. Mindy Cohen, author of The Women of Austin Powers and Austin, Take Me, I'm Yours, believes that Austin's success with the opposite sex transcends his job title.
There are so many reasons why women are fascinated and captivated by Austin Powers. It's the way he flicks his hair, the way he chews, the way he wears his hat, the way he sips his tea. The memory of all that, no, they can't take that away from me.
Perhaps no one is more familiar with the inner workings of Austin Powers and his charms than longtime friend and comic actor Mike Myers, often mistaken as the Master Shagger himself, except that he has better teeth and less chest hair. Myers first met the legendary swinger where today's hip singles the world over now congregate. And by the word hip, I mean lonely and desperate.
I met Austin Powers at a, online actually, in a chat room. Which was a chat room discussing Austin Powers, strangely enough. And he was doing what they call vanity surfing.
The two became fast friends, even appearing in the same digitally enhanced photos. Soon Mike was observing the secret to Austin's success with women.
Austin treats all the girls very well, just being loved and adored all the time. He's got the mojo, the essence, if you will, the life force.
Here now is a rare archival interview of Austin surrounded by two reprogrammed but still dangerously alluring fembots. In it, he explains his life force and mojo.
For me, everything rolls around the mojo. You know what I mean? The sexuality, for example. Does this make you horny? Does it? The shape of it? Does it make you horny? To you, is this Eros manifest? Does it make you randy, baby?
According to longtime friend and fellow spy, Mrs. Kensington, Austin's randy charms work particularly well on a particular type of woman.
I think the Austin Powers woman is strong, intelligent, dynamic. I think a very keen sense of style. And rather large breaths. I think going into a perilous situation, being dressed provocatively and looking hot, if you will, adds a tremendous element, a tremendous advantage in the situation, because you can't overestimate the powers of distraction.
Austin is a scared little sissy, Mary.
Evil henchwoman Frau Farbissina argues that an Austin woman is nothing more than a sexy bimbo.
The kind of woman that would fall for Austin Powers is just a fool, a temptress, a, you know, whore. I am practically naked. Oh, find me. Oh, I tripped. I fell. I don't do that.
While the tough-talking Fraulein might not appreciate Austin's sexy sidekicks, her fellow evil henchman number two does.
I've been very attracted to the women that Austin has showed up with. I'm sure we'd all like to flog them a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
The list of Austin's floggable friends isn't limited to just good gals with large breasts. He's also slept with the enemy. They too had large breasts and colorful names. Ivana Humpalot, A Lot of Vagina, and Robin Swallows.
Swallows, that's an interesting name.
Maiden name Spitz.
Well, which is it, baby? Spitz or Swallows?
He has never failed to deliver the goods. And that, as you say in America, is the bottom line.
According to Mike Myers, though, Austin's ability to attract the opposite sex goes beyond the relative values of good and evil. It goes into the heart and soul of being a woman.
Look, I'm not much of a psychologist when it comes to talking about the women of Austin Powers, but if I had to say offhand, throw out a theory, I would have to say that it's somewhere between the Electra complex and the notion of the grandiose self as defined in the DSM-3 book when they discuss the whole idea of the malignant narcissist. It is sublimated to the point where she no longer can rely on all of those things that tell her who she is and what she's all about. It's what Shakespeare referred to as losing yourself to find oneself. But that's just off the cuff. I don't have much science to support that.
The list of Austin Powers women goes on and on, as do their reasons for being bed by the master bedder. That's right, I said master bedder. When Spyography returns, we'll see more of Austin Powers' adventures and meet the women at his side and bedside.
Tomorrow at 11, no longer ashamed of their lifestyles.
I'm definitely a heterosexual.
Mixed gender couples are marching for acceptance. Ed Helms gets the straight story on the heterosexual agenda. The Daily Show with Jon Stewart tomorrow at 11, only on Comedy Central.
Real Comedy is brought to you by Austin Powers and Goldmember, in theaters July 26th.
Escape pod? The all-new Toyota Matrix. That's something else.
Warning! This video contains explicit material not suitable for children. Think you've seen it all before? Think again. Because now Girls Gone Wild takes you to dozens of the top party schools across the USA. Introducing Girls Gone Wild on campus, an all-new, off-the-hook, totally uncensored video packed with hundreds of stunning real college girls. Hit the clubs with out-of-control undergrads, hang out with hot sorority sisters exposing it all, and crash the craziest frat parties ever caught on tape. It's not sold in stores and can't be shown on TV. So call now and get the all-new Girls Gone Wild on campus, yours on video or DVD for just $9.99. Use your credit card and we'll also send you the all-new Girls Gone Wild dorm room fantasies free. Come inside actual college dorms and see what happens when these sexy co-eds act out their most private fantasies. You'll get two all-new videos, raw, real, and uncut, for only $9.99. Then be the first to preview the latest Girls Gone Wild videos. Satisfaction guaranteed. Cancel anytime. If you're over 18, call 1-800-946-6688 to order Girls Gone Wild on campus. Video or DVD for only $9.99. Use your credit card to get dorm room fantasies free. Call now, 1-800-946-6688. Or see more action now at girlsgonewild.com.
If your life is one adventure after another, you need to explore the Dodge Summer Clearance Event and the bold new Dodge Ram Quad Cab. Four full-size doors coupled with a full-size bed, plus Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, Honda, or Toyota don't match it. And now get a cash allowance of up to $3,000 or 0% APR financing that could save you up to $7,000 on Durango. All of which now make Dodge man's newest best friend at the Dodge Summer Clearance Event.
Arena football on the new TNN. Harder, faster, and totally out of control. Arena football. Everything is cracked up to be.
Welcome back to Comedy Central's Spyography, The Women of Austin Powers. It has been said that to fully understand the Austin Powers phenomenon and his libidinous effect on women, men, and the occasional barnyard animal, one must understand his adventures. While I'm not certain who said that, I'm quite certain it was said, at least by me just moments ago. His latest exploits and sexploits are about to be unveiled in the new film, Goldmember. His longtime friend, Mike Myers, tells Spyography a little about the film.
The film is a journey for Austin to shed himself of the need of his father's approval. We find out that there's a new character called Nigel Powers, and that's Austin Powers' dad. And he was England's number one most famous spy that Austin's been living in the shadow of.
Nigel Powers is very much like Austin. You know, they love their women, they love the power. You know, they really are father and son.
Tragically, his father, who is a very colorful and lively figure in himself, is kidnapped.
Don't worry, Dad. I'm here to rescue you.
Ow. He does so with in partnership with the delightful Foxy Cleopatra.
Foxy Cleopatra. She is the ultimate, isn't she, in sexuality? When I first saw Foxy, my patch even started to get tight.
Hello, hello.
In this film, we learn the apple hasn't fallen very far from the tree.
Aren't you going to introduce us, Austin?
Foxy, this is...
Powers. Nigel Powers. Is that eau de Flores you're wearing?
Yes, it is.
That's how a woman should smell.
She's a no-nonsense, tough, street-smart gal from the blaxploitation movies of the 70s.
I'm Foxy Cleopatra, and I'm a whole lot of woman. Shazam!
She's very cool. And she's one mean, but she's not yet a mother, but she's mean.
The first time we meet Foxy, she's undercover and she's singing. First time you see her, she's on the stage with this hot gold outfit on and this cool hair, this cool afro. That's the first time Austin actually sees Foxy in years, and they make a connection while she's performing, and she tries to hint to watch out for Goldmember.
Goldmember is a Dutch metallurgical hedonist by the name of Johan van der Schmutt. He owns a club in the 70s called Studio 69, and he's just your typical kind of swinger from Europe. And he's Dutch.
Everybody, I'm from Holland. Isn't that weird? Yes.
Goldmember lost his manhood in an unfortunate smelting accident, and he then decided to call himself Goldmember. He's also got a club in which everything is gold and you have to be a member of the club to get in. So it works both ways, you see. Goldmember for his manhood and gold, yeah.
Through Goldmember and Dr. Evil, Austin's mojo will get tested in a way that will make women want him all the more.
I am a sexy beast.
Some say that Austin attracts the ladies because he's a sexy spy in an ugly business. This contrast is never more apparent than when he meets a fellow agent called the Mole.
He has a horrible, huge, disgusting, massive, eruptive mole.
By the way, I realize that I have a large mole on my face.
Where? What? Where's that mole? I didn't see one.
And every time he walks into the room, that's the only thing that you ever see is this massive, huge, bubble-like mole.
I also realize the irony that I am myself a mole.
No one would make that connection.
Yeah, I'm a fat bastard is back.
When the two face off, women will once again be repulsed by the big bad guy and seduced by Austin's courage.
Well, I don't know what to say about it. Here's one fat bastard.
When Comedy Central's biography, The Women of Austin Powers, returns, we'll meet the one woman in the world capable of resisting Austin Powers' power. Austin's power. And the superstar who wants to be his next hoochie coochie mama.
TV Geek.
Confident, combative, has seen every episode of Cheers, yet no one knows his name.
I knew who shot JR before he did.
Beat the Geeks, tomorrow at 7:30, only on Comedy Central.
Prepare for battle.
You crazy, Troy.
What?
It's a blind date. I told her I was going to be wearing a blue shirt. Blue shirt. Go in there, check her out,
text you. That's it.
That's it.
With Nokia's 3360 and AT&T wireless service.
Troy. Troy.
No.
You can send and receive text messages.
Troy had to run.
Oh! And right now, get a $30 rebate from AT&T Wireless.
What's wrong, Jim?
I think I've grown a second evil head.
Hey, I'm sorry. What if we go get a refreshing Mike's Hard Iced Tea? Would that help?
I didn't know Mike's made a hard iced tea.
You bet they do.
A hard day calls for a hard iced tea. Make it Mike's.
I'm the one causing the trouble here.
The shocker comedy you've been waiting for. It's the underground comedy movie, available only through this special TV offer. Damn funny, say critics, and the single most offensive movie ever made.
Oh, not now, honey, not now.
With supermodels in the job, taking a with Gina Lee Nolan, Michael Clark Duncan, Slash, and Joey Buttafuoco. Music by NoFX, Guttermouth, and more. Composed of hardcore, brutal, in-your-face skits such as The Porno Review, Arnold Schwollenbecker, Donna of the Dead, Dickman Fights Lesbians. The censors won't allow us to show you how far this movie really goes. The underground comedy movie is guaranteed to offend your money back. Only $19.95. Order now and get a bonus video absolutely free. That's two videos for only $19.95. Can't charge it? No problem. Debit it. Also available on DVD. Don't wait. Call now to guarantee the bonus video. Call the number on your screen now. Must be 18 to order.
Welcome back to Comedy Central's biography, The Women of Austin Powers. The international man of mysteries world, as we have learned, is a very stimulating one. Very stimulating indeed. Now, in a biography exclusive, we'll meet the one woman whom Austin will never attain, or in other words, is made of unobtainium, and talk to a singing sensation who dreams of running her hands through his fine chest hair. Yes, that's it. Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy?
Well, there are two groups of women in the world, those who have been with Austin, those who have not been with Austin. I would say to the group of women who have been with Austin, they're a very fortunate group. For the women who have not been with Austin, I would simply say don't give up hope.
One woman who clings to that hope is multi-Grammy winner, singer Beyoncé Knowles.
See, there's my Austin there. He's the last thing I see before I go to sleep and the first thing I see when I wake up in the morning. Austin.
Austin first caught her eye when the international man of mystery saved the world. But it was a near career-ending accident that caught her heart.
The first time Austin went up against Dr. Evil and busted his plans for world domination, I thought, now that is one cool dude. But then I heard he lost his mojo for a while.
I've lost my mojo!
That really got to me. I'm a sucker for hurt puppies and that kind of thing. And I suppose that's when he got into my radar big time. Now he's going mano-mano against Goldmember, and I can't get him out of my mind.
Apparently Beyoncé, the singer, has a crush on Austin. I mean, who wouldn't, right? She's a woman, that's all you need.
Well, I happen to know for a fact that Austin thinks she's bootylicious.
Let me tell you, I'm not gonna be another notch under Austin's belt.
I think Austin, from what he's told me, loves these women a lot, and they're not just another notch in his belt. They're also a notch in his bedstand and a notch on his headboard.
Every hey, baby.
Austin, in case you're watching, my number is 323-555-5453. Call me.
Regardless of his fame or reputation, I just don't know if any woman could resist him.
Spyography has learned that there is such a woman.
Is he really that desirable? I think he's you know, kind of funny looking with his tousled hair and his teeth and, you know, his shag, baby shag. And it never works out. He must not be very good in bed.
She's the one thing that he probably will always seek and never get. Forbissena, forbidden. I took some German.
I think he's a big joke because he doesn't really, really know how to please a woman. Not like, you know, the lover of all times, Dr. Evil.
The love of one woman and the hatred of another. I think we can all relate to that. I know I can. All one can say is thank God for restraining orders. Coming up, we'll see what's next for Austin and all of his gal pals when Spyography, The Women of Austin Powers returns. Okay, not all, but a lot when Spyography, The Women of Austin Powers returns.
Who you are. Everybody's got a little diet doing them.
You know, that's my kind of woman.
So don't hold back. Do the diet do.
These guys aren't ours?
No, civilians.
The best and brightest of the bottom of the barrel.
You want to send that on a mission of national security?
I think it's time we tried something new.
Revolution Studios presents a new breed.
Not bad.
Of secret agent.
This is gonna be one hell of a trip.
Vin Diesel is Triple X. Rated PG-13. In theaters everywhere, August 9th.
Beauty. Adventure. Drama. All these and more can be yours in the wonderful world of art. And with this free art test from Art Instruction Schools, you can find out if you have the interest and desire needed to become a serious art student. To get your free art test without cost or obligation, call this toll-free number. Don't delay. Call this toll-free number now. Call 1-800-862-1000.
Associates, all the help the law allows.
Kids, you gotta love their energy until you have to take it on the road. Dodge Grand Caravan to the rescue. Get one now and get a cool kid pacifying rear seat video player at no extra charge, so you can keep your eyes on the road and your sanity intact, more or less.
Comedy Central is the best place for stand-up, but in case you forget, we'll remind you every week. Remix! Monday nights, the best stand-up from the best in the stand-up business. Comic Remix, tomorrow night at 10, only on Comedy Central. Remix!
Welcome back to Comedy Central's Spyography, The Women of Austin Powers. We've met many of his women and learned what makes them tick. The burning question remains, is Austin a good spooner? And what's next for these lucky ladies? Actually, I guess that's two questions.
I don't know if Austin is a good spooner or not. I'm hoping to find out.
Yes, Austin's a spooner, but he's more of a grapefruit spooner. You know, he likes to cuddle, but there's an edge, you know?
Superb spooner Austin Powers has maintained his edge. But how have the many women of Austin Powers fared?
Mrs. Kensington has become a cryptozoologist studying animals that are of a mythical nature.
I know that Vanessa has just blown up. Bam! Turns out she was a fembot.
Oh, thank God.
Felicity Shagwell got married to a guy named John Alday, but she kept her name, so her name is Felicity Shagwell Alday. Ivana Humpalot has gone through a lot of changes. She's changed her name as well. Her name is Ivana Hump, but only in a committed relationship, a lot. A lot of vagina got very sick of being a spy and having people make fun of her name. So she now lives on a remote desert island. She's changed her name to Sandy Vagina.
But what of all the other women who seek the rapture that apparently only Austin can offer?
I have just a small pearl of advice for all the women who have ever loved Austin Powers. You will never obtain him. You will never harness him. It's like that Sting song, you know? When you love someone, just let them just walk out that door.
Well, I would just tell the women of Austin Powers, you know, good luck with your quest. I just don't think Austin is also that, you know, but keep away from my man.
So what's next for the elusive and effusive international man of mystery?
I think Austin Powers feels complete. I think it was a good journey, he was telling me. He got knighted by the Queen, which made him happy. You know what they say, once a spy, always a spy, but once a knight is enough. Otherwise, you could get sore.
I don't know what's next for Austin. I guess it's that whole international man of mystery thing. Very hard to predict. I know that I'm gonna rush out and see Goldmember. It's like being on a date with Austin, only he's really not there.
Even after the scrutiny of the spyography spyglass, Austin Powers remains very much the mysterious international man of mystery. Despite that redundancy, it has been said that in order to understand the man, the myth, and his many mistresses, one should see Austin Powers in Goldmember. It was a studio executive who told me to say that, but it is sage advice nonetheless. For Comedy Central's Spyography, I'm Robert Culp. Good night.
Yeah! Woo, baby!
Woo!
God, life is stupid.